praise the Lord. May God's name be glorified. Welcome to the Republic Day video of Sevak Ministry. Today, as India celebrates the Republic Day, the 75th Republic Day, it's important to understand, you know, how that applies to you and to me and what God would want for us to know on this day. So when we think about, you know, our forefathers, my grandfather and many of my relatives, they were freedom fighters, standing along with, you know, Nehru and Gandhi and all the other freedom fighters. They fought, and you know, many of my relatives died so that you and I could be free. It was not an easy thing. And yet, after winning the battle against the Britishers, you know, India was still not free because there was no constitution. So the first president, B.R. Ambedkar, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, he was, you know, God used him to write our first constitution. And when that was published and accepted, India became a like sovereign nation. India was a republic where there was the thing about justice and all the values that India so holds on to. And as you and I think about that day, it's important to understand how that applies to us. Just like, you know, how the work of independence was done by through the sacrifice of countless people, including my family and maybe some of your families. And, you know, we yet did not receive the freedom until it was a Republic Day 75 years ago. Jesus Christ, who is God, he came down to this earth and he shed his blood. You know, in the book of Hebrews, in chapter 9, verse 15, it reads, "For this reason, Christ is the mediator of a new covenant, that those who are called may receive the promised eternal inheritance. Now that he has died as a ransom to set them free from the sins committed under the first covenant." So you and I, we were not, you know, perfect people. We are not still perfect people. We sin with our thoughts, we sin with our words, we sin with our actions. And if you think about it, you know, God, the Lord Jesus, he paid that price. He died for you and me on that cross. But just because he died, you and I will not be automatically forgiven. You and I will not automatically become children of God. You and I will not automatically be heirs of that covenant that God is freely giving. It'll only happen when you and I receive him as our Lord and Savior. In John chapter 1, verse 11 and 12, and it's one of my favorite verses, it says, "He came to his own." He came to the Lord Jesus, the one who created the heavens and the earth, the one who left all the glory of heaven. He came down to this earth for what? So that he came to his own, yet his own did not receive him. You know, people who were supposed to, you know, be welcoming him, abandoned him. And not only abandoned him, they crucified him. He came to his own received him not, but to as many as received him. Doesn't matter if you are from a Hindu background, from a Muslim background, a Christian background, whatever is your background, it does not matter. But as many as received him, to them who believed in his name, if you and I, we believe that yes, we were sinners and we know how God loved us, that he left heaven's glory. He came down, he humbled himself, and he even humbled himself to the point he would die for us. When you believe that, and that he died for your and my sins, and he came back to life on the third day. What happens? When we believe him, as many as received him, to them he gave the right to be the children of God. You and I need to receive him. That's the key part. Just like when our forefathers won the war of independence, India still was not independent. Even though the Lord Jesus died, you and I still can be in our sins until we receive him. It is very important today to examine, have you actually received him? Or are you just a Christian or just thinking that I'll go to heaven because I come from a good family, because I've done such and such thing, or I have, you know, I'm trying real hard? No, none of that will work. You can only be a child of God, adopted, forgiven, and become his friend, his beloved, only when you receive him. Will you receive him into your heart today? I pray, and we all pray, that God would speak to you this time, that you would become a child of God. You would be truly set free. Jesus said, whom the Son sets free will be free indeed. Do you want to receive the true freedom? Do you want to be set free from all the cares and all the bondage of sin? All the addictions, all that is pulling you down, ask Jesus, the Lord, to come to your heart today. May God help you. May God's name be glorified.